Here the topic is solving a system of linear equations using substitution. So the idea for substitution is you want to isolate one variable, meaning get one letter all by itself on one side of the equation. Once we do that, we can use what it's equivalent to plug into the other equation. So if you notice in part A, I already have one variable all by itself, which means this expression is equivalent to x. So in the second equation, instead of writing x, we will use its equivalent expression, which means the bottom equation will become 5 times 3y plus 11 plus 2y equal to 21. And if I distribute, I will get 15y plus 55 plus 2y equal to 21. If I minus 55 on both sides, I will get 17y equal to negative 34. And then if I solve for y, I can divide by 17, and I will get that y is negative 2. Now, that's one part of the solution. Remember, systems of equations, the solution is a point, so we need an x-coordinate and a y-coordinate. I have the y-coordinate, I'm just missing the x-coordinate. So we go back into that top equation, and instead of writing y, rewrite what y is equivalent to. And after all of the computation, you figure out that x is actually equal to 5. So the solution here will be the point, x value comma y value. And that is the solution to the system of equations. Now B is a little bit more difficult. B does not have a letter isolated already. And yes, you can isolate whichever variable you want, x or y, and you can use whichever equation you want, top equation or bottom equation. But some equations and some variables will be easier to solve for than others. For example, in part B, you notice that the bottom equation has the variable y with the single coefficient of positive 1. If you have an equation that has a single variable with the coefficient of positive 1, that is going to be your easiest variable to isolate. So I'm going to take the bottom equation and isolate the y, which means I will need to move over the 2x by adding 2x to both sides. When I do that, I get y equals positive 2x minus 7. Since I used the bottom equation to solve for y, that value for y, this expression here, has to get plugged into the top equation, which means that this y will now become the 2x minus 7. So I have 5x minus 4 times 2x minus 7 equal to 22. If I distribute the negative 4, I get 5x minus 8x plus 28 equal to 22. And then if I minus 28 on both sides, these two together make minus 3x, and that makes negative 6. Divide by negative 3 to solve for x, and we get that x is positive 2. Again, this is a system of linear equations, which means my solution should be a point. I have the x-coordinate of that point. What I'm missing is the y-coordinate of that point. However, I can use any equation that I have from the beginning. I can use the original top equation, the original bottom equation, or I could even use the manipulated bottom equation. Since the manipulated bottom equation will tell me y equals whatever it is, that's what I'm going to use. So I'm going to take that manipulated equation and plug in 2 for x, and I get that y equals negative 3. So my solution here is a point. 2 is the x coordinate of that point, negative 3 is the y coordinate of that point, and that is the solution. Now, if I would have taken this 2 and plugged it in here and then solved for y, I would have still got y equal to negative 3. If I would have plugged that 2 into here and solved for this y, I still would have ended up with y equal to negative 3. So it makes no difference on which equation, the top, the bottom, or the manipulated one. Any of those, you're able to plug in your first solution, okay, to get the whole entire solution, which is the coordinates of a point.